killing me.
And Terry Labonte, a lot of damage to the nose of that car.
What if he tore it up?
All right. Episode 16 in the 2024 finale of the Neighborhood Fun series, you know, the very last one of 2024 before it really starts getting cold. You know, because, you know, we only have very little time left, all right, this Adventures in Autumn season 4 production before, you know, winter eventually gets here, which, you know, it usually the wind up is us. The Sandy Ridge finale, usually shortly after the Checkered Parts 500 at Phoenix. And usually what's sandwiched in between that and Thanksgiving and the Thanksgiving festivities starting with, well, which would have started, all this would have started last year if we didn't have Not Far Health acting up and giving us that mild cold. In between the Friendsgiving and the Oliveras, Thanksgiving with the Oliveras is the week after. And, you know, the Sandy Ridge finale would have been the Sandy Ridge walk-off finale. So this year, it's like a 50-50, you know, lottery chance that we'll get a walk-off finale this year, no matter if the actual finale is a disaster or not. Because last year was a disaster. The walk-off would have like been a mini redemption story to make up for it, but us not dressing accordingly was, no one was to blame for that but ourselves. And so, as you guys may have heard on my community tab, those over on my Facebook and Instagram and my main TikTok, something bad did happen to me yesterday. Well, not to me directly, but something bad happened to me generally. So, therefore, but not only am I not saying what it is, the privacy reasons, for the sake of the personal privacy of my family, but there will be no campaign this time. So, therefore, we're just going to have to deal with that on the fly because of the fact that, you know, there won't be enough time for another campaign during this current season 4 of Adventures in Autumn because we only have so little time of, you know, decent weather left. Get the fuck out of here, butterfly, before it really starts getting cold and, you know, winter makes its grand return for us on December 1st. So, therefore, and I get it. Fall seems like a semi-long season, but in terms of how the longevity, it's nothing. What it feels like is like it's nothing compared to spring. Spring feels like a semi-long eternity. Summer feels like a whole day. I mean, fall is just like, you know, maybe a whole week or something, but winter, it's like 60 decades, it feels like. So, therefore, of course, we're not going to have enough time for another campaign because, you know, there's only room for one campaign in the fall season when something bad happens to us. When we started this whole campaign thing with the finish what we started ordeal. So, in this case, we're just going to have to deal with it and work with what we got and, go from here. So, yeah, I mean, as expected, the kids were very excited to see me because I disappeared for a really long time because of either how chilly the weather had gotten recently or before that, even on the nicest days in terms of the weather, we'd come home, get too comfortable in bed and fall asleep. But today was not one of those days, thankfully. So anyway, like I was saying, there's only room in the Adventures in Autumn, you know, production every year from, because this all started with the whole finish what we started thing. Because it was the first of hopefully the only 3 times where Julie broke her heart. Where it was just, you know, a misunderstanding of some sort of the 3 times we broke up on and off. But it looks like we got things patched and squared away now. And considering I've had the crush on her for the longest time, our relationship's not dying anytime, permanently dying anytime soon. If it does die, it would only have to be temporary based off the history. But when we got our heart broken the first time, we were like so tempted to like get to season 4 of Fun in the Sun because it was going to be a redemption tour based on how atrocious season 3 was in 2023. But then I told myself, okay, fine, we're almost there. We can do our summer activities of content on YouTube and TikTok. That's fine. But just do not just rush into it because it's unhealthy. You got to finish what you started. And that's how that all started. And then we got a heartbroken by Julie a second of 3 times. Then that's when we started the whole midsummer bounce back around the time the Spurs got Chris Paul. So that all ended with, you know, Emma Bachman's grad party, as you all know. It was during Brook Park weekend, and unfortunately we were not able to make the dance in, over by Sanders this year as much as we tried, because I remember how I guaranteed we were naked back there this past summer after the success of the docuseries a year ago. I just, you know, considering how I said in the outro, where I said, after 5 months of planning this and, you know, being back here for the first time since 2019, it was 5 years at the time, I believe. 22, 21, 29. No, it's 4 years at the time, my bad. It was 4 years at the time since the day after my sister's wedding during in the middle of my recent last YouTube break. Just never tell anyone what you're going to do ahead of time, because sometimes it isn't proven to be correct, unfortunately. It's a 50-50 chance that'll be proven to correct. And that other 50%, unfortunately, was not correct. I did say we were going to be back this past season four of Fun in the Sun, you know, before the Sandy Ridge Redemption name was even thought of, because that's when I thought the summer of 2023, as bad as that first half was, except for the very beginning, was going to turn around. And boy, was I wrong. But that's neither here or there. But unfortunately, we did not make the dance in Brook Park this year because of how badly my mom was still hurting at the time, which she has gotten a hell of a lot better since then. Not perfect anywhere, perfect by any means, but it's a lot better now than what it was then. And that was around the time my grandmother eventually went to the hospital the first of two times. The first time was like a one-and-done deal. They figured out the first problem. But then when my sister came to town to visit, you know, so it was, you know, my niece's, Rusty Wallace's, second birthday, and it was the first time my younger niece was meeting everybody, then, yeah, that's when she went into the hospital for a week. And, you know, that's when we started this unfinished business campaign. We took so many, well, no, we spent a lot of time at home, you know, catching up on some unfinished business where some TikToks and dances and YouTube videos, a lot of them were done to make up for what all those missed opportunities at the beginning of the summer in the first half when the TikTok ratio was weak. Hold on. Here I'm my man Jason, so therefore I just want to finish that story. What was I saying? You know what? We're gonna pause the channel identification. We'll come back in a minute with that story. Okay, now I remember what I was going to say, but, more on that in a little bit. So we spent a lot of time at home, you know, after the 4th of July Brook Park, you know, halfway point, you know, catching up on TikTok dances that we could have done before, you know, before the Devil's Canyon trilogy, you know, mid to late June of earlier this year, and a bunch of YouTube videos that, you know, could have filled the empty spaces of voids that could have been filled. I mean, better late than never, I suppose, but man, that was like the longest campaign. Unfinished business, you know, that all started with Anna Grace Barlow's Jeff Green 30th birthday when we did our first of many NASCAR hauls. So, therefore, we've come a long way, improving the channel and you're making it evolve so very, very well. New thumbnails, in terms of, you know, editing them, attracting more people, and, you know, decorating them as well as other YouTubers do that are, like, you know, are regular people, but, like, you know, get more views, get more comments, have more subscribers, and are wealthier than me by doing this stuff more frequently on an average basis than I do. We've been, you know, retiring, you know, old elements or scaling back to part-time and bringing in, you know, new elements, you know. And then I forgot when this campaign ended. I forgot when it did. I don't even know who's that coming down the street. That's Doug and Rachel. Rachel's in the driver's seat. Yeah, I don't even remember when that campaign finished, if we're being honest. I'm too lazy to look right now, but once we finally got that done with, it was just clear sailing to the finish from there. With, you know, the College Farewell Tour, the Corn Fest, that, you know, Chevrolet Monte Carlo 400 debacle at Richmond with Austin, you know, the start of football season in the nation with Rangers versus Pioneers 8th grade. Let me see here. Rangers versus Pioneers 8th grade. I had to stop there for a split second. You know, to avoid getting street signs and make sure I didn't get Raptor Gaming 129's dad without, you know, him knowing that he's on camera, even though he's not really paying attention, but still. Let me see here. We had the end of summer explosion, which was very tame. Our first volleyball game in God knows how long, since I believe it was 2017. I believe, you know, when we started going to these Ranger sporting events as well as these school sporting events in general to support our friends that are still in school, even the ones that we supported when they were still in school, we supported that are obviously not in school anymore, have gotten older, grown up, and, you know, gotten cars and licenses, had boyfriends and girlfriends, have engagements, they've gotten married, had kids, you know, stuff like that. There's Demon Dobie and his little brother, so... Yeah, so that was our first volleyball game. And then, you know, that, you know, way how we closed out the summer and rung in the fall. That was exciting, you know. And then we had 11 years on YouTube on September 7th. September 6th. I'm sorry. No, September. My brain is going out 20 places. It has been going 20 places and like 20 different places for the last week and a half. So my apologies if some of my sentences sound out of whack. So September 6th was our 11-year YouTube anniversary. My number one girl best friend, Brinley Kerr's Elliot Sadler 21st birthday. I mean, we've been mighty busy. I mean, we've had the chase for the cup begin in NASCAR. We've, you know, started making preview videos for like to like get ready for some of these races. Been what, tuning into more races even on a part-time basis. Look out. All right, so we've been tuning into more races even on a part-time basis. And giving more race reviews. I mean, we did go to, you know, reunite with my dad's cousin, Elias, there to go see his son play Oliver. Play an exhibition, like, baseball game that was just, you know, meaningless. It had no winners or losers. He just played it just for shits and giggles. You know, to the point where, I mean, Oliver's team, as y'all remember, closed out the game strong. If there was a game where they were keeping score and there was our win-loss column system, that would have resulted in a win if it were older kids. So, but since they're really little, you know, Oliver, Tanner, I feel like in those ages it wouldn't be fair if one team won and the other team lost, because, you know, kids don't handle losses as well. Like, I mean, older kids do. But, like, they're sure as nobody likes to lose, but older kids handle it a little bit better than younger kids do. That's why, you know, they don't have a system where, you know, the one with the most points wins and you have less than that, you lose. They didn't do that, which was fair. And then the sinus ear infection, the week of the Sharpie 500, and then that, just like, you know, the smile code last year that screwed us out of that walk-off in finale in Sandy Ridge and the Friendsgiving. You know, that screwed us out of potential 80 degree days we could have, you know, spent, you know, on making TikTok dances, YouTube videos, you know, all that jazz. But sometimes things aren't meant to be, unfortunately. That's just the way it is. I mean, you can't always get what you want. You win some, you lose some. You live by the sword, you die by the sword, you live and you learn. We most definitely have come a long way since the sinus ear infection went away. And then even during the times where it was chilly and we disappeared and, you know, I haven't seen anybody for 15 days or more, or maybe a little less than that in between. And, let me see here, You know, even when on days like this where it's beautiful, but we come home, get so comfortable in bed, get our YouTube fix on right away, get something to eat, get a small bite to eat, but we get so comfortable, we lay down and fall asleep by the time we wake up, it's way too late to come outside, to the point where it's already past the time where my mom would have already wanted me in the house. So thank the Lord for these, you know, Lord, these lower to mid 70 degree days that way that they're blessing, that the weather gods are blessing us with now to make up for all that. Because one last thing I'll say before we show you any excitement, if any, Night of the Centuries tomorrow. Of course, not only this, the third night of, annual Night of the Century since the is the first inception in 2022, but this will be this particular, you know, late October, early November event will be making its YouTube debut. So I look forward to broadcasting that. And then the day after, we got our fall randomness. And then Thursday, guess what? Bang, bang, Tito Puente. Go Spurs, go. So enjoy this last bit of, you know, outdoor time of freedom without having to worry about editing on TV while we still have it. Because starting on Thursdays, at least if I'm and beyond, at least for the most part, whenever we can, whether we can tune in at all or even stay up for the whole thing, we got some Spurs basketball to watch with Oh Mama, Wembanyama, and CP3. So we're, if anything, excited so far. It's been mellow here in the happiest place in Northeast Ohio. So therefore, if something exciting happens, we'll break it and show it to you. But until then, please stand by. Your mics are hot.
6.5 hours later.
Introducing friends to friends. Finally, we got some excitement. Sean, Jessica, and the dog is Stella. Mikey, Rachel.
Yeah, she's a beagle.
Beagles. It's too small. She wants small dogs. I want a dog about this tall.
These dogs are medium-sized dogs. They're not small.
Did you know that I went to their daughter's birthday party back in September?
That's good fun.
Yeah, they invited me over the weekend of the Atlanta Chase race in NASCAR. Oh yeah, but that one you gave me a straight up invite. That one I wanted to surprise you. For the Claire one. That was part of my summer prologue, keep in mind. You can thank me for that.
This is Haley and Claire.
Haley and Claire. Though these are the two we celebrated birthdays for. She's September, she's I think June or May.
June.
Gotcha. Yeah, June. And when the before I came to give you your congratulatory wedding TikTok, I came to her Steve Park first birthday party at the end of it. That was part of my summer prologue. Yeah. Yeah, and I went to her birthday party the day before the Napa 500 at Atlanta Motor Speedway to kick off the 2024 Chase for the Cup.
I'm stuck.
Why did you stop moving? That's the real question.
Yeah, I wanted two of my friends to meet each other.
I moved in October and she joined me in May.
I was one of the first to meet him.
Where'd you guys move from? Homestead.
Okay, that's nice.
Yeah.
It is. That's why we call this the happiest place in Northeast Ohio, just like the Disney or Florida Disney. I always get Disneyland and Disney World mixed up.
Well, we gotta keep going. They're just gonna
go crazy. Nice to meet you. Thanks, guys.
A few minutes later.
Man, is there ever gonna be a walk, Claire, one of these days where you're not gonna be crying before you grow out of this baby funk?
Yeah, Claire, what's up with that?
One day you'll get it right. Oh, now that's a wall. That's a wall. Jerry Springer lady.
again. Clap again. All right, Dale. Just don't hit that wall like the real one did at Daytona 23 years ago. I thought she was going to run into that wall.
We're going to park it.
Park it in the garage. Take it to the garage. Can you see if we can make some repairs?
Turn it back on.
Turn it back on. Left. There you go. Nope. Wrong way. Turn it around.
We're backing it in, I see.
Watch you don't hit anything. Oh, this is the best parallel parking you'll ever see. I think we had enough.
All done.
Can I help? It's kind of tricky.
What the fuck is this shit? You better run, your family's leaving you. You're welcome. Holy fucking shit.
I think we're done here. It's getting chilly out, but I wanted to get one last neighborhood fun episode in before it eventually got cold full time. So, oh shit, I got a block. Okay. Okay, I was just trying to figure out who that was. But anyway, no TikTok dances were done on this day. They're going that way. But anyway, so no TikTok dances were done on this day, but that's okay. Wow, I mean, luckily, we have the next two nights to bail us out, tomorrow and the day after, especially tomorrow, because guess what's making its YouTube debut for like its third ever running? Night of the Century in Sandy Ridge. Going to be probably the warmest day in, you know, this usually takes place on the warmest fall day during Adventures in Autumn production. And I was thinking about, you know, recording the, like, you know, the shave and, you know, just for old time's sake, but I don't want to make this video longer than it needs to be, so we're just going to park the bus, shave, and, you know, and take a shower, like, you know, casually off camera, and then get ready for tomorrow. So, therefore, until next time, this is Mark Oliveira signing off. So, we had a tame first half, but an exciting second half, so let's just hope we have an exciting day and night all around tomorrow, and hopefully do better than whatever the fuck last year's Night of the Century was. So, obviously, we should have scheduled it the day before the planned day we set, but hey, we didn't know. But anyway, have a good night tonight and a better day tomorrow. Take care, everyone. Good night. See you all for the next video, which will be the first ever YouTube recording of Night of the Century. Come, you know, for the third running up. See you all tomorrow for the next video, which will be the annual YouTube debut of Night of the Century in Sandy Ridge, which will be the third annual running since its inception in 2022. See you later, everyone.